Last we left our heroes, they had been struggling with the accusations of a murder of a man within the most popular theater within the trading city, Breeze. After a quick discussion with the party, and a common decision to have a few party members sneak out during the late hours of the night, you discovered that the wife of the man was also pronounced missing, and then promptly after, deceased. With that, you have discovered a strange-looking man creating markings in the alleyway next to the theater, while unconscious guards were posted outside of the building. You returned to the Shattered Cup Inn, slept through the night, and were awoken by the guards asking you to meet them downstairs. Having a brief discussion, he told the party the same news that you had discovered last night, and said that you were no longer under suspicion. You then decided to leave the city immediately, following the direction of the rumors, ending up at a strange cemetery with a fallen oak tree along the main entrance. Upon quick investigation, you heard voices coming from the crypt behind the tree, just before skeletons rose from the above-ground tombs. And that's where we're going to start. We're going to start with battle, boys. I need you all to roll initiative.
Hold on, yeah. My character sheet's fucked up.
Again?
That's not good.
No, it's literally, what it doesn't show anything.
I'm going to skip this because I feel
I'm pretty
like
sure
it's...
that one's copyrighted.
Oh, hey, this is from Two Steps from Hell.
Of course you know that. Of course you know that. No. Remember the milk.
Remember yeah, this is. Isn't this Heart of Courage?
I have no idea.
I'm gonna reopen this.
Ugh. I rolled a 2 for initiative. That's some bullshit.
He rolled on that one. That sucks.
I'm coming back. Oh yeah,
where's
that really does suck.
Where's initiative? There we go. Now I would like to public roll. Suck my feet.
Okay.
Yeah.
No, it's still fucked up.
I'll spam it. Here, I'll look at it.
Right, oh, no wonder. Never mind. It was on spells.
I like that we're not all here.
Mickey.
Yeah.
Oh, wait, never mind. Yeah. There I am. I'm just.
I don't know
I'm
why
just fucking
open
stupid.
To that. And I'd be like, sit there and be like, why?
Okay.
Man, I know there's something I wanted to try last session and now I don't remember what it was.
I got a 15 for mine.
Okay.
This is a squeaky toy.
I'm a bird.
But yes, you are, but you don't commonly go.
Do you want me to roll
I
for
will.
Quentin and Bella?
Yeah, one sec.
Well, I'll roll for him because I've got physical dice.
Who am I missing? Zephyr, Elizabeth, Wynn, Sheikah.
I know, I'm trying to look at something real quick.
Jalfay.
Jalfay's on there.
Where is he?
Yeah. But you're public rolling.
Me?
Yeah. If you don't want
I've
us to know
Yuri,
that.
And your
also,
ass
that's
is
fucking crazy.
Now.
Jesus.
I mean, it's in the turn order, so it's not that big of a deal. But...
Okay, fair.
Okay. So who got what? Let me see. So
I got 8.
I got a 2. Elizabeth got an 8.
Oh hey, I got 19.
You have plus 4 to initiative? What the fuck?
Me? Yeah.
God damn.
Wynn
that's
got
crazy.
10. Sheikah got a 19. Okay.
And I've got everybody else's.
What did you
get, Drew? I got 15.
Okay.
Quentin got 19 plus his initiative thing.
That's right.
Why does the fucking skeleton have plus 2 initiative?
Did you do Bella's too?
Yeah, what's Bella's?
Yeah, Bella's is 18 plus her initiative.
Bro, which skeleton's the one that's fucking ready to fuck shit up?
I think he just did
yeah,
it as
I'm
a group.
I'm rolling for
so.
All of them. Yeah.
Wait, but how did it roll higher than 20?
Does it have
if you
plus
have plus,
initiative?
You can.
That's what I'm saying. Why does the skeleton have plus initiative?
Because
he,
Bella has
he
a 22.
Came out of a.
Bella goes first.
Damn. That's crazy.
Okay. So here we go.
Oof.
Let's see, I gotta open up Bella's character sheet. Okay. So, after seeing them rise from the ground, she is going to run over to this one here and attack with the short sword. Is that with... Oh, the auto rolls. I gotta open up that character sheet too.
Oh shit, there's four skeletons. I got so many character
sheets open. Yes, there are. So she goes, she runs over to him, goes in for a swing, and it kind of, the skeleton, like, as it's emerging, it kind of goes through the rib cage that, but it's an empty gap as she swings, so she completely misses the attack.
Oh, fat whiff.
Big whiff from Bella here, and that is going to conclude her turn.
Wait, so do the skeletons all have the same turn?
Yeah.
Yes, they all have the same turn, so they're all going to go simultaneously.
Yikes.
That's
kind
of strange, but all right.
Oh, yeah, that's kind of crazy.
That's how I'm going to run combat, because the more, like, with a lot of different NPCs, it kind of gets confusing if they all have different things. So, I don't know.
It also takes so much longer if they all have to roll.
So, as the skeleton is rising from the ground, and Ina goes in to slice it in the ribcage, and as it whiffs, the skeleton is going to try and do the same thing, stand up, and kind of try and jam... Ina in the neck. Is this rolling with advantage?
Apparently.
Looks like it.
Okay. Character sheet. Sorry. I gotta turn that off. Advantage. I'm probably gonna have to do this for all of them. Okay. Let me try that again. 16, so that totally hits.
I don't think you scaled it.
Oh shit, I did not mean to do that.
What do you mean scaled it?
Okay.
It's hitting for 20?
It's not hitting for 20. That's no, rolling it, for that the attack hit. To see
yeah,
if it
that's
hits.
Rolling for the attack, and then...
Okay.
So... 7 damage.
Quit.
Bella gets jammed in the neck with the short sword, and the skeleton pulls out. With that attack.
Ouch.
Okay, this skeleton is going to... Let's see, how long is this?
We'll get to lower Bella's health.
I guess so.
Oh, okay. I just can't see that.
That's weird. I wonder why that doesn't
color didn't
show
change.
Up on that.
That's not good.
Yeah, here.
Bad info for me.
Okay, so this one runs up to Wind Triskel, does the same thing. It's going to go in for a short sword roll. What's your AC?
He's not in there.
What's
Trevor? He's going to bed. Get on.
What's your AC, Laura? Wind?
My armor class?
Yes.
14.
Yep. Armor class. 14? It just whiffs. So it runs up. It kind of emerges from the ground and, like, does a crawl action and then, like, gets up in a stand, sprints over, goes in with a slice, and whiffs.
Why not?
This one.
What is this?
This one is going to.
Yeah,
I
forgot about that.
It's gonna move over here and go for a short bow attack on Zephyr.
Oh, how dare you!
What's your armor class?
13.
Zephyr? 13, so it hits. You take 3 damage! Woo!
Down to 10, you fuck.
Oh shit, bro!
And this one. This one is going to strafe over here and do the same thing on Ugral.
Can it see me from there?
Yeah, it has a clear line of sight. What's your armor class?
I'm 14.
14. Ooh. So it emerges from the ground, kind of crawls over a bit, pulls out its short bow, fires, and the arrow whizzes by you. And that's the end of the skeleton's turns. Sheikah!
Now your turn. You always do your laundry when I do it.
Nice. Okay, so I will be, let's get out of there, moving to here.
Okay.
And attacking with monk unarmed.
Zhaofei should have moved after Ina, by the way. I don't know why the turn order was messed up like that.
Oh, the whole thing. Oh, that's good. So 22 with 5 damage, or bludgeoning.
Yeah, totally hits, it takes 5 damage.
That's weird, usually you have to roll for the damage by itself.
Yeah, I set that up. I set it up so it doesn't do that.
Nice.
Also, the skeleton, you sock it in its bone, and you feel the jaw kind of like dislocate, but it's still hanging on.
Crunchy. A little bit.
Can you attack twice with unarmed strike?
I can attack twice more if I use a key point, but I'm gonna wait.
Okay, fair. Okay, is there anything else you want to do on your turn? After this, it's Ugral, then Wynn, by the way.
I'm good for now.
Okay.
I'll wait.
Sweet. Ugral, it is your turn, and then after is Wynn. Wynn is up next.
Alright.
Give me mallet.
How is Bella looking?
If I could smack him.
Or Ina.
I don't know why it's not showing up on her.
She's so long, dude.
15 out of 22.
Okay, she's fine.
Isn't Zephyr at like 10?
Yeah, I'm at 10 health.
What up?
Yeah.
Okay, never mind. Sorry, dude, you sounded weird. Fuck for me.
All good.
We made it, boys. Yeah.
I know. Boop, boop. I have to kill Trevor's character somehow.
Yeah, I know. That's why I texted you. I was like, are you gonna do it? Alright, I gotta get my babies.
I'm gonna move.
I hate being a nice guy.
Just over here. And then I will.
Kylie.
I really wanna do that.
What?
Does Trevor work tomorrow?
Yeah, I'll do it. I'll look at Zach or Zephyr. I'll look at Zephyr and then I will.
I don't think he'll care too much though. Kylie, you wanna go shopping with me tomorrow?
Can you?
Hide up. Get in here.
I wanted to go grocery shopping with Nikki tomorrow. Get in here. Now I work tomorrow.
I'm listening, Drew.
I'm listening to Drew.
Alright, I'm gonna look at Zephyr and I'm gonna touch my balls. No, I'm gonna touch my.
Hey, did you wait for me? Oh, you did?
Yeah. Well, no. I rolled for your initiative, and then the turn order was messed up for some reason, and you didn't go. But it's whatever.
Okay, that's fine.
Just held your whole turn.
Oh, that's why.
Yeah, it's whatever. But I'm gonna look at Zephyr. I'm gonna touch my god's thingy, my talisman or whatever.
Okay.
And I'm gonna look at Zach, and I'm gonna say, "How are you?" And once I get to you, I'm gonna cast healing word on him.
Okay, so roll your d4 for the health modifier.
Yeah, and as you see this, my eyes glow a little bit and you can see the word travel through the air and heal Zach for
cool.
Casting for 7 health. God damn.
Okay, you're at full attack.
Yeah, I was gonna say, it just puts me back to full.
That's my low healing one, too.
What?
Hey, yo!
I know.
Okay, is that the end of your turn?
Well, I still have an action. Yeah, that's only my bonus action.
Holy shit, okay.
Yeah, I know, it's great. But for my action.
Oh yeah, go for it. No.
You know, For my action, I'll hold my action until
Bro, can I tell you guys something real quick?
I'm gonna try.
I don't think I've ever seen Kylie look like she wanted to like murder herself ever before until today. You know what?
Murder herself?
Yeah, dude. I came home from my lunch.
I'm gonna.
Kylie thought she lost her fucking hamster all day.
I'm gonna move
right?
over here.
She got out.
And then I'm gonna cast dishes. Guidance on Wynn.
Okay.
So I'm like doing dishes, and Kylie walks in the house.
I'll
and, like,
describe
she looks
it
like
in a second.
She was trying to hold back crying. She looked like she was like holding in her tears so fucking hard. I said, Kylie, did you find your hamster? She's like, no.
Okay.
RP.
Right, as you see me move over to Laura, you see my character kind of lose consciousness for a second as I touch Laura and my talisman, and my eyes kind of flicker for a second, and then you see Wynn's like paws or whatever the fuck
my grippers.
Her grippers her grippers.
Oh no.
You see her grippers glow subtly.
Okay. Sweet. Is that the end of your turn?
Yeah, and now you have guidance, Laura, and that's I'll put that in chat.
This music's crazy.
It is.
Okay.
It's kind of epic.
One willing.
Alright, Wynn, it's your turn, and then Elizabeth is up next.
I'm trying to remember how to use my spells, like the easy way. Where are my cantrips, dog? How do I use this shit?
You have to go to your spells.
I'm in my spells.
Spells, you have Druidcraft and Shillelagh. Shillelagh.
Your cantrips should be top left.
Okay.
You're trying to Shillelagh?
Shillelagh, dog. Okay, so you pull out a mistletoe and a shamrock leaf.
Wait,
and
hold on. What does this do? It sends it to you.
Yeah. So.
Yeah. I'm using my stuff.
Okay. Yeah. So you pull out a mistletoe and a shamrock with your quarterstaff. You kind of rub it against, and it starts to glow with this green energy.
I'm muttering words of encouragement under my breath.
And so now it's imbued, and you can use your spell modifier, which is wisdom. Sorry, I'm clicking around. Which is wisdom to make the attacks. So, and we said for bludgeoning, or for the quarterstaff after this, you use a d10 for the two-handed strike.
Okay, so I'm just rolling a d10?
D10 plus your wisdom modifier.
The turn order is in an annoying spot.
Then move it.
You roll for the attack first. That might be.
What did I do that again?
Roll your Shillelagh.
No,
your cool. Yeah, your quarterstaff. Just click on quarterstaff. Or no, it's a wisdom modifier. So it's a d20 plus 4.
So
can't you just click her wisdom?
I mean, I could.
Yeah, you can. Yeah, click your wisdom, and then you will do 8 plus 4. So if this hits, it'll do 12 damage. So click on wisdom.
I am. It's fucking asking me if I want to do a public roll. That's why it's not going. I was like, go!
11.
Yeah,
so.
No, hold on. With Drew's spell, can't she roll a d4?
It's
and
an
add
ability
to that?
Check. No.
What's an ability?
An ability check is
roll
like
a d4 and add the number rolled to one ability check.
Like
choice.
If we
wait, I rolled a d10 for my wisdom. Why did I roll a d10?
You didn't.
No, so you rolled a d20,
but you rolled a seven.
You rolled a seven. So you go in to strike after the quarterstaff starts to glow. You go in for a strike across the jaw that Sheikah just broke, and you as it goes
fucking
in, like whiff. The jaw dislocates just in time for the mouth. Like it to go right in between the mouth, and you whiff the attack.
Joy.
Oh, damn.
Oof. And that's the end. Is that the end of your turn? Do you want to move?
No, I'm good.
Okay. Elizabeth, it's your turn, and then Zephyr is up next.
Sweet. Okay. I would like to cast my Hail of Thorns.
Okay. So. You're over here, by the way.
So far away.
Right. How long can my longbow reach, actually?
You can shoot 120 feet, I think, or 150 feet?
Damn.
Yeah, it's 150 feet with disadvantage, right?
Spell my Hail of Thorns. I don't really know how to do that. Do I click on it?
Okay. Yeah, click on it.
At what level?
Level one, I think.
No or two.
I know, but you
okay,
have to.
Okay, so I have to make a deep dexterity. Can't cast at level two. Which skeleton are you trying to shoot?
I want to shoot the one that's really close to Laura and Nikki.
Okay, so you're trying to weave in between the trees to shoot us. Okay.
Kind of, I'd move first, actually.
Well, no, it's kind of guarded by Nikki and Laura, so right, I'll say for the narrative, like, you're so familiar with the trees and everything that you kind of know how the branches work because you're a wood elf, and you can kind of make this shot. She's a wood elf. So I have to make a... What kind of... I have to make a dexterity saving throw. Oh, wait, no, that's not a saving throw. I don't think it has anything for saving throws. No, it gets a plus zero to saving throws. So I roll 1d20 plus nothing. 9! So, yes. So it takes 5 damage. As soon as you fire an arrow, it'll take that damage.
Okay. Who's taking damage so far?
Ina and Zephyr, but I healed Zephyr.
Yep.
So I fire an arrow yet?
Hmm? Yes.
Okay.
Go ahead and fire your arrow. So if you go to your core and click on longbow, it should fire an arrow.
Boop.
Damn, bro, Bella wilding right now.
She is wild.
I'm clicking it.
She whiffed as well.
Where is she?
Weapon proficiency. I don't think you're clicking the right thing.
Where's Bella?
Yeah, you gotta go to character sheet.
Not here yet.
If you click on longbow plus 5 in the...
Attacks and spellcasting.
Yeah.
It's above your money.
Yep, just above your money, you should see... Fighting style archery, and then if you go up more, it says longbow plus 5.
What? Yeah, wrong one.
Okay. Oh no! Ah,
6.
No!
That one.
So you go and fire this arrow, and it courses through the trees perfectly fine, but then as it gets to the skeleton, it kind of falls short, like right before.
What a shot!
That's so sad.
I know, you set up for a cool thing too. I feel bad.
Does the Hail of Thorns hit?
Bro,
or
this
is that...
120.
No, that's only if she hits with the arrow.
Feet.
Okay.
Yep. So, Zephyr, it's your turn, and then Ina's on deck. So,
I have one
technically,
Jaffe. So on False Life, it says components VSM, a small amount of alcohol, and distilled spirits. Does that mean I have to have that in order to cast it?
Yeah, that's how we're playing.
Okay. So I was wondering. Damn, so means that bow that was spell we can't fucking use.
You gotta buy that shit in town, man.
I've never had the opportunity because we keep getting imprisoned. We all just got
No. Yeah, you all got imprisoned. Let's keep it a buck. You all. It was a part of the narrative.
Yeah, but he gets imprisoned more often than.
I've never gone to prison. Trevor did.
Oh, yeah, Trevor did.
You get away.
Yeah.
Quentin gets every away time. With it.
On that note, I am gonna shoot. Fuck, dude.
Do this one.
Hold up. That's what I was thinking. Either this one or the one in the far back. The one in the far back is kind of looking like a bitch.
this one.
What type of weapon? What type of creature can use Morning Star?
We're gonna go Chaos Bolt into one of the
spiders
behind the house on the right side.
Okay.
Hello, Bella.
This one.
Yep, I need to go. I fucking
load into roll 20 really quick. You're next, Bella.
I'm already in.
Drew, what are you as a character?
What?
Oh, nice. And it already select the fire too. Dope.
What are you as a character?
Yep. Cleric. So you.
Huh?
Cleric. Not fighter.
Wait, is this Chaos Bolt?
Trevor's a fighter.
No, Firebolt.
Okay. So, yeah, what's your question?
Is there anyone else here that's a fighter besides fucking dead ass Trevor?
Nope.
Just dead ass Trevor.
Yep, just dead ass Trevor. So
is a Morningstar a simple weapon, by the way?
Go lay down.
Or no?
No, I think it's a martial weapon.
Oh, okay.
Oh, hey, I do martial stuff.
Oh, hey, Nick, you want a weapon?
Yeah, but you couldn't take much of a hit.
Okay, so Zephyr pulls out this liquid, jams it into his arm, like a needle, and presses in the syringe, and his hand starts to ignite with fire, and he goes in for the shot of fire, and it gets pretty close to the skeleton, but dissipates right in front of it, right before it makes it, right before it connects.
Damn, we suck. On that note, I'm gonna fucking get a little bit further back.
It's Ina's turn. I did one turn for you.
Who's done damage so far?
We are very proud of you.
This one's taking damage.
Thank you.
This one hasn't taken damage. Yeah.
This one. Yeah.
Okay, I'm gonna use the short sword off skeleton in front of me.
Okay, go for it.
Damn, bro, Bella's following me right now.
Sorry. Okay, right. Okay.
Oh, that totally hits. And five damage to it.
You're gonna get a snack.
Okay, so you go. So after whiffing with the short sword, she comes back around for the slash in the torso again, and that one connects.
You whiffed the first time?
Yeah, I did. Okay.
My door was getting stuck.
It connects and it kind of breaks one of the rib cages as it does. So, is there anything else you want to do?
Chill. Not
chill. Go back.
Cat going in right now. What did you say, Bella?
No, that's it.
Okay. Sweet. It is Jiaofei's turn, and then Sheikah, you're after the skeleton.
Who's not wearing armor?
All of you
guys.
Is
Nikki or Laura wearing armor?
Nikki is not wearing armor.
I don't think Laura is.
Yeah, Nikki does not. Necessarily.
I can't. Yeah. I shouldn't wear armor.
When armor doesn't not help her, I don't think.
So I'm going to run. I'm going to use poop.
Okay, mage armor.
I'm gonna go touch Nikki with it.
Whoa.
Okay, so 13 plus your dex modifier is your new AC.
Hold on.
Wait, hold on. My computer. Yeah. Also, you should keep a note of what your normal DC is. 17.
Big game to get my milkies.
Wait, so what was it?
Your normal AC is 17, but this is 13 plus your dex modifier.
Oh, shit.
I don't know. I think you might have just
I think it's the same
her.
Thing. Yeah, it's the same thing.
Oh, my dex modifier is 4.
Yeah, so it's the same 17. Thing. So it looks cool.
I touched Laura.
Well, no, would it not?
Touches. Woo!
So, so he runs over to Sheikah, puts his hand on her, and like a faint glimmer happens, and then he's like, "Ah, wait, I don't want to do it on you." And then he slaps Wynn in her ear as the spell's like starting to form on Sheikah, and then it just transfers over to Wynn.
Fantastic.
What's your... your dex is... Whatever... It's 13 plus your dex modifier.
And I'm looking at my dex modifier.
Mm.
Which is literally just like under dexterity, or along the side, the left
number.
Side.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's the big number.
1.
14 is your new AC.
And what is that? Armor class?
What was your AC before? Yeah.
That 14. It would be 14.
Wait, no, it's Quentin's, I'm pretty sure. Hold on. The target's base AC becomes 13 plus its dex modifier. No, it is.
It's dex modifier, so.
Okay, so it's on win. It's the same, but, I mean, it's on win.
Sorry.
That would not help me.
This skill is useless. Get fucking rid of it. I don't want it anymore. Get rid of this and falls like, fuck those two moves, bro.
You already touched them. Already did it. Get rid of a fucking spell slot.
Truth. This music is crazy. Is that the end of your turn?
Yeah.
Okay. It is now the skeleton's turn. This one in close combat with Ina.
Four of us. Oh.
Yeah. The four of you guys. It's going to go in for another short sword attack.
Bro, so basically I'm useless after two more turns.
Oh.
It, that totally hits, right? 20?
Yeah.
Cantrips 16, you can use unlimited.
1d6. Okay. So you take 4 damage. Ina takes 4 damage there. This one is going to do the same thing. Right here, this one. It's going to go in for a short sword attack on Sheikah, and it completely whiffs. So, you being agile, it goes down for a slash on your wing and misses completely. This guy, on the other hand, is going to fire at Wynn, because everybody is
behind
Wynn for whatever reason. that totally misses again. It pulls out another arrow that it has, fires it, and it falls short right in front of Wynn. And then this one, who does it have line of sight on? Zephyr and Ugral. This one is gonna fire on Ugral here. 17, does that hit?
Yeah.
Okay. You take 8 damage.
Ow.
So the other one like kind of cracks its bones out of place and fires an arrow and it right into the shoulder and it that one stung a little bit. And that's the skeleton's turn. Sheikah, it is your turn with Ugral up next.
Nice, cool. I'm using a talon attack on this bitch.
Okay, go for it.
Going now. Oh shit, never mind.
7. So you go into, you jump up in the air, try and go in with your talons, and it misses the attack.
Cool.
It kind of bobs and weaves out of the way a little bit. It's
Nicky sees the whiffing.
Corrupted form.
I am. Okay, I'm going to spend 1 key point to do 2 monk unarmed attacks, okay?
Go for it.
There's one. Oh shit!
That totally hits. 7 damage. Okay, so you watch. Why isn't this working?
What are you? You gotta get out of the ruler.
Oh, I am in the ruler. Thank you. So you go in for the strike. After the talons miss, you land and then go in for the strike, and it breaks the entire spine of the skeleton, and the bones just crumple on the floor, killing the thing.
Aww. It dies? Shit.
It dies.
Well, so much for my 2 arm strikes. Oh well.
Okay, murder. Okay. Is there anything else you want to do here?
I can move now, right?
Yeah, you can move.
Nice. Let's see.
Let's go, Nicky!
Woohoo! I'm gonna go over here for support.
Okay. Sounds good.
Cool, that's the end of me.
Okay, Ugral and then Wynn on deck.
Alright. This fucking sucks ass. But I'm gonna, I'm gonna touch my talisman and touch myself and cast Cure Wounds on myself. And okay, you'll notice that my eyes glow more than they did when I killed Zach.
When you were fondling everybody else?
Yeah, I was fondling.
He likes himself the most.
Mm-hmm. I can think of it's very bright lights.
It is.
Like you just that. See him in the back corner just playing on himself. He's just like, what the fuck, dude?
Yeah, that's
eyes just glowing gold. He's like, ah!
Kill myself for 8 points. So I'm back to full.
It's hurt just a little bit just to keep going.
Anything else?
I'm gonna move behind this tree. Okay. I imagine like the trunk is like here, so I'll just move there.
Okay, deal. When it's your turn with Elizabeth on deck.
I am unmuted, right? Okay, cool.
Yeah.
I'm getting me fucking mallet, so it's D20 first.
Yes, plus your
see
wisdom.
See if I hit.
Or no, plus your...
Oh, so I can just... Yeah, I just roll wisdom. Yeah.
You just click on wisdom, yeah.
But this guy's dead, so I wouldn't hit him.
True.
That
get
guy's
out
alive.
Of here!
All these guys are alive.
There's my fucking roll 20 is bugging, but it's fine.
Are they really alive, though?
Well, they're... Yeah.
Are they really dead?
They're undead.
I can walk over. Okay. Yeah. I was seeing if I had to, like, rabbit run.
No.
Yeah, you can go over there.
Okay.
Perfect.
And now I roll wisdom.
Yes. You roll wisdom. So all of your movement's gone.
Yeah. What is he gonna do? Short,
that totally hits.
Point blank?
And then you roll a d10. Plus, let me see. 1d8 bludgeoning, so that would be 0, but it's taking wisdom, so plus 4. So, 10 damage. So you run up to it, and you give it a good old smack in its skeletal body, and it kind of dislocates the spinal cords in the back. It looks very hurt.
Good. Brokeback Mountain.
Yeah. Is there anything else you want to do here?
I don't think so.
Okay. Elizabeth, then Zephyr are up next.
Okay.
So, to cast Hunter's Mark, it says I need a bonus action.
Yeah, so you get an action, which is shooting your longbow, a bonus action, which is your Hunter's Thorn, and movement. That's all that you can do in one turn.
I thought the movement counted as a bonus action.
No. It's all separate.
Okay. I want to move... I want to move... here. 40. Oh wait, how... I can only move like 20.
You can only move 30.
Okay, I'm gonna go as far as I can. I'm gonna go near Zach.
Okay, go for it.
Why can't I move? Oh.
Right here.
Select move. Why can't I move myself?
You should be able to.
You have to get out of the ruler and click on there. Yeah, oh wait.
I'm
you
on my
goobs.
Mouse. I'm on my mouse tool.
Here, let me.
I'm making mouse pick a tool.
I'm on the right tool.
Yeah, I don't know why it's not working. There you go. Try now.
It's just highlighted.
Still no?
Yeah.
Huh. Okay, you want to move here or here?
There.
Okay.
I'm at now. Sorry.
Perfect. I don't know. I'll have to look into that. I'm sorry. I don't know why that's working.
Okay, and then I can shoot still, right?
Yeah.
Yes, you can shoot and do Hail of Thorns if you want to.
Okay, I want to shoot with Hail of Thorns to that skeleton right there.
Okay, go for it.
I almost clicked the
roll your longbow, and then roll your... And then I have to make a dexterity check. Or dexterity saving throw.
No!
Oh, that's so sad!
Why do I suck? I can't fight today or something.
She goes in for an arrow, and this time it just goes so far wide, it's ridiculous. And like, you hear somebody in the background like,
she's actually using the bow backwards and not realizing.
Yeah, she's like shooting it at herself. Okay.
She's pushing the string.
That's the end of your turn, unless you have anything that you can use as a bonus action.
Not really, no.
Okay.
So. Okay.
Yep, it's Zach's turn. Zephyr's turn.
So I would like to use my light crossbow. But the thing is, if I'm reading this right, I can do this twice with repeating shot. I'll put that in chat so that everyone can see. So in other words, I just use it twice technically, right?
This magic grants a plus one bonus attack and damage rolls made. Yeah. So you fire it and you don't have to load again.
Yeah, I don't have to load again, so I fire it twice. So I'm, right.
Mm-hmm. So you put in two arrows.
Yeah. Okay, go ahead.
Or two bolts into the crossbow. I probably should go for the fire.
There we go.
On this guy.
The one on the my fucking little screen.
That guy. Okay.
Yeah.
Right. So you put two bolts in. And they fire simultaneously, and they both kind of like do this snaking motion in the air, and then completely go wide and don't hit the skeleton at all.
God damn it, dude! No. Kylie, you know what? Elizabeth, let's just like fucking dip out of this place.
Yeah,
this place sucks.
Run away.
I need a drink. Let's go. We're just here for emotional support.
It looks like you guys already have too many to drink.
I gotta remove a bolt.
Alright, it's Ina's turn now. If Bella's here. Bella, Ina.
Ah.
Bella, Ina. Not,
why is this
not
beer
Laura.
So fucking hard to open?
She is good?
Alright, yeah, it's your turn.
Sorry. Mom was talking to me. Okay.
How dare
she? Let's see. I know. I'm trying to play a video game, Mom. Can you not? So, I'm gonna do short sword.
Mm-hmm.
On skeleton again.
Go for it.
Okay. That's what I'm doing.
So, you go in again for the attack, and you slice down. And
no.
It misses again.
Really?
For the second time.
Okay.
I think you can use a bonus action to attack again, if I'm not mistaken.
I thought I didn't have one until level 3. From my knowledge. Oh.
Is that what that says? Yeah. This action could be used.
Well,
oh no. Dash, disengage, or hide. Yeah, no. So never mind.
Well, I want a cunning action right now. So.
Okay. So you're gonna disengage.
I'm gonna move to I'll go here.
Okay. Bang. And that's all that you can do. So you cunning action, disengage, and move over there. That's, you still have, not that much movement, I don't think. Yeah, you still have 20 feet of movement if you want to, but.
I'm good.
Okay. Jiaofei, and then Chica. Quentin and Chica.
Noise.
Alright, let's see. Oh, that's so sad.
Oh, you suck.
So you go into fire a chaos bolt.
Mm-hmm.
And you rear it back, and then you fire it, but you couldn't pick a target because there's a lot of skeletons around. So you just kind of shoot it and see where it goes, and it goes, like, over here. Wait, completely that's missing any target.
Quentin's joined the cool gang.
Can't hit her the shot. Missing gang. Soul Let's gang. Go.
The emotional support gang.
Alright. So, after seeing Ina run away, the skeleton, and turning and seeing a bird there, it's gonna go in for a short sword attack on Chica. And it misses completely, so it goes in for a short sword, and you kind of just hop off the ground with your wings kind of flapping and then land, and it kind of goes under you. This one is going to move over to Ina, and when you get an attack of opportunity.
Laura.
What?
Laura, attack of opportunity.
Oh, fog.
On this guy.
Yeah, so do your whole thing again.
Do it.
Wisdom, and then... That nice. Totally hits. Roll your damage. So 1d10. Plus I'm your fine. Wisdom modifier. Yeah, that guy's dead. So as it starts to run over to Ina, Wind kind of smacks it in its shin, and then the entire body, like, crumbles again.
Can it make a Sans Undertale sound when it dies?
And it falls to the ground and dies.
Fantastic.
I don't know why that's not showing up. But there you go. So this one is going to move up one and take a shot at Jiaofei here.
Oh shit.
What's your armor class, Quentin?
Twelve?
Oh shit.
So that totally hits. You take 7 points of damage, so it strafes to the side. This skeleton's kind of on a roll, but pulls
Based
back
my
an
armor
arrow.
Class?
Yeah, your armor class. No, your HP. Your HP. Yeah, so five damage. Whatever your HP is, minus five.
My hit points?
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah.
So you're down
or minus seven. Yeah. Whatever that is, minus seven. So 12 minus 7, which is 6.
Oh no!
Or no, 5.
When did I just squish
you? See, you have 5 HP now. And that's all the skeletons wrote for their turn. So now it is Chica and with Ubral on deck.
Okay, nice. We're just gonna do a normal monk on arm strike and on this guy. Hope it works.
Go for it.
Damn.
Yeah, that totally hits. So you watch this bird fly up again, go in for like a power strike down, and completely decimate this skeleton. Utterly. That thing is gonzo. Is there anything else you want to do on your turn?
Let's see. Yeah, I'm gonna move over Shit, I didn't measure that correctly. Move over here. Yeah. Perfect.
Sweet. Okay. And that's the end of your turn.
Yep.
Ugral and then Winds on deck.
Alright. Is this an action?
Okay,
bonus action. So I'm gonna grab my symbol and I'm gonna say, hold on, what the fuck is this name? I'm gonna say, Bahamut, oh, I need your divine power right now, and I'm gonna get another spell slot back. And then I'm gonna immediately use healing word on Zhaofei. I'm gonna be like, don't get hit. And when I say hit, it's gonna heal him. And I'm gonna heal him for 5.
Okay. So, Quentin, you now have 10 HP.
When you now have 10 HP, I healed you for 5.
All right, and, is it the end of your turn? You do move.
Yeah, I'm gonna move around the tree over here. I'm gonna try to hide from that skeleton. Yeah.
Okay. Deal. Win.
Yeah.
It is now your turn with Elizabeth on deck.
Yeah. Turn order. Move. Get out of him. I've accidentally entered the skeleton.
Okay. Go for it. Go for it. Wisdom.
I got to pull back up. And then minimize it every time to hit public roll.
Just bring it up in a
second. I missed.
So you go in and the skeleton like sees you coming and like ducks as soon as you go in for like a slide strike on its neck. It completely dodges your attack. Okay, it is now Elizabeth's turn with Zephyr on deck.
All right, let's get it, Elizabeth. I have faith in us. We might help.
Guys. Hit your shots, Kylie. Hit your shots.
It's like Valorant.
Right?
It's like
no.
I'm rooting for you. I'm rooting for you.
Okay. So I'll move.
Yeah, that totally. Yeah, we'll say that like,
there.
As people are sliding in and like moving, you fire an arrow at the skeleton.
Where'd you want to move? She said she wanted to move.
Oh, you wanted to move?
Well, I mean, can I hit? I guess I can.
You can hit him from there.
Okay. Yeah, I'll just shoot him from there, I guess. Worth a shot. Okay. Same. I can cast my same spell, right?
Yep.
Okay.
18, that hits!
Yay!
Roll. Okay, so you're doing this with Hail of Thorns. So I have to roll 1d20. 18. So it saves on the Hail of Thorns, but you still do damage to it with the arrow.
That's all that matters.
So,
got damage on the board.
What? So you roll, what's your damage for your arrow? It's 1d8 plus 3. So on the dice thing, click on d8 and then add 3 to whatever you roll. I don't have the thing set up for Kylie, though. 7 plus 3 is 10. So this arrow kind of glides in as people are sliding and moving around. The arrow glides in and knocks the skeleton, like, in what would be its eye, but it's just a socket, and it kind of knocks it onto the ground a little bit, and then it gets back up. This thing is looking pretty hurt. Zephyr, it is now your turn with Ina on
I'm
deck.
Closing the gap because this is... I'm fucking tired of... Oh, wait, I got him on the ruler. Hold up. Fucking ruler, you bitch. Alright, I'm right there. We're getting close. We're getting personal.
Okay.
Join me, brother.
And we're doing the same thing, the crossbow. Am I still able to do the repeating shot? That's not. That's like. That's because it's part of my class, isn't it?
I think. I believe so.
Yeah.
A simple.
It doesn't say anything against.
You're attuned to your weapon.
Yeah. So the same thing?
Yeah, you can do that. Go for it.
Boom. Double crossbow, I like fucking.
Yeah, both of them
run
hit,
in. So I do a fucking somersault, smack one, slide in, and smack another. Let's
there
go.
There you go. Fucking yeah, the thing is decimated. So as you fire those, the arrows like, or the crossbow bolts sink into the rib cages and
your
the skeleton crumples to the ground.
Where did they go?
The skeleton crumples to the ground. And the thing is decimated.
Fucking, let's get it, Kylie.
That is
we helped. We helped.
That is the end of the combat here. You did it.
Ooh, I have one spell left. I can heal one more time.
Okay. So after all of the chaos has subsided. With the skeletons rising from their graves, the environment kind of gets still a little bit. And you still, getting closer to the crypt, you do hear, like, voices inside, but you aren't sure where they're coming from.
Are you from rolling perception, or are we...
You can do whatever. At this point, it's whatever you want to do here.
I want to investigate the fucking bodies.
The skeletons?
Well,
the skeleton bodies. I want to do that. Do I need to do an investigation on that, or?
Yeah. Roll an investigation check.
Check the bodies and see what... Check them out, you know. 19.
Nice.
19? So, after rummaging through, you've got a little bit of dust from the bones, but it doesn't...
Bone dust.
They weren't really carrying anything on them. You've got a few, You can find maybe a few copper coins on them, like...
Okay.
Five total, maybe. But these skeletons were not that rich.
All right.
They were in their graves.
I also just learned something about my character. Apparently, every time I've healed, I've actually healed three more. Because I'm a disciple of life. So, my healing spells are more effective. So, Quinn, heal yourself for three more.
So, I think you're full now,
because it's an
additional
hit point equal to 2 plus the spell's level. And I've been casting everything at level 1 because that's all I can do.
Okay. Sweet.
Read my character.
Yeah, maybe.
It helps, doesn't it?
It does.
Okay.
Perception.
Yeah, go for it. A little perception check.
I want to see what's around here.
I did say at the end of last session that the crypt was slightly open.
Right.
So yeah, walking over there, you can definitely hear voices, and they sound like chants. More than actual voices. They sound like there's a
We've stumbled
going on.
Upon a cult.
What do you guys want to do here?
I want to go join the cult.
You want to go into the crypt?
Oh, cult.
That...
cult.
Yeah. I want to join the cult.
Get the cult. No.
Okay. So here's where we are now. I think it's dark actually. Oh no, there's torches.
It's right. Okay. I can see in the dark.
So you guys
for sure, all of us can.
Most of you guys can.
I have no idea.
I think it's everybody but Trevor.
I'm putting everybody in here.
I'll be right here.
Okay, deal.
Where me at?
We all just.
I think that's everybody.
Like...
1, 2, 3.
This makes me nervous.
The switch, Zach and I. Because Zach said he was going in. I'm gonna be
okay,
the one
so
of people
the
yeah.
cult, man.
Leroy Jenkins.
No.
Okay.
No.
What do you guys want to do here?
Where's the cards? I want to use detect magic.
Okay, go ahead and cast it. So actually, you does it.
I gotta find it. Let's see. Where's my detect magic?
So walking into the crypt, you can immediately tell that there have been people in here consistently. It's kind of dark and empty. And kind of forbidding. There's two statues that stand guarding entrance, it looks like. Yeah, so you cast detect magic and the armor looks there's a glow on the armor.
Okay. I want to inspect the armor or investigate more into the armor.
Okay, roll an investigation check.
I gotta go back to my sheet. Jesus Christ. Investigation. Oh, public fucking thing. 19 again.
Oh, 19. Shit. So you walk over and just... So which one do you want to investigate?
The one that's glowing. Of course.
No, they both are.
They both are. Is there a distinct glow between the two? Is one shining brighter than the other? No,
they're both like they're both like a fluorescent blue color.
Do I like select one on the screen?
Yeah, just like ping it. Like there or there.
I'm gonna go to the bottom one since it's closer.
Okay. So you run over to the bottom one, and as you're like investigating it slightly, you see that actually they begin to shift in movement and they become alive.
Ah, fuck! God damn it.
So this is a surprise attack, so this guy, the one that you were investigating, takes damage here. I should actually just keep the...
I shouldn't, like, just check it out. I should have just, like, poked it with a stick. Touching things with your mitts, dog.
Put your grippers away, Zach.
I thought I was going to get some cool armor that was just sitting there, but you know what?
Oof.
Sorry, Laura. I kind of activated their trap card.
I see that.
Okay. So... It's going, so as it awakes from as you're investigating, it awakens and it kind of, you hear the armor clanking and it kind of does like a shove action right into you. Let's see. Oh, it rolled for advantage. Fuck.
Well, that's disadvantage, but yeah.
Isn't that an advantage though?
No,
it highlighted it doesn't. 8, so.
It doesn't get advantage. It's a surprise attack, so it gets a free round on you. So 23.
Okay.
That totally hits.
We shouldn't have said anything. I wish you didn't notice that.
And then so it does 4 damage to you, Zach. So
fuck.
It kind of awakens, shifts in movement, and then it kind of right into you, and you feel like HP. It's very hard.
Well, yeah, it's a fucking armor. Some sturdy armor. Okay.
And so yeah, you take 4 damage. And it kind of knocks you back a little bit, but doesn't move you at all.
Okay.
And then it's gonna actually go in for another attack on you.
Okay.
Yikes.
And that's a 15. What's your
son of bitch? 13.
13. Okay. And this one, it slams into you twice. It kind of. And the other one's a little bit harder, and it does 6 damage to you on the second attack.
I've got 3 health, guys.
Hey, Zach.
Okay, and now we roll initiative again.
Noted, never fucking with glowy things again.
Please.
Never
we roll
again.
Initiative.
We all have to roll initiative?
Yep, roll initiative.
I got 3.
I got 18.
Okay.
We wanted to send the result of this to the turn tracker, but an invalid token was selected.
He just reads it and puts it in there anyway.
Oh, hey, I got mine added.
Do it again, Zach.
Wait, what the fuck?
Guys, if you click your token,
oh, that's bullshit. I wanted 18 though. Yeah, no, it said you wanted.
If you click your token and click initiative, it adds it to the turn tracker.
Okay.
Oh,
and
I got 19.
Fuck, dude, I just rolled worse and worse.
Wait, what?
I'm good at
dying. If you
Like when you select slash move your token, you gotta like select
it. Yeah, so you click on your token, then
and then you click your initiative.
Roll
your initiative.
Exact. What's your dex?
Where is my token? What the fuck are you talking
about?
We
got the same number. What's your dex?
It's your person, dude. It's your little wind triskel bunny rabbit bitch.
Yeah, when I click on that, it just brings up token settings. Name,
don't bring up the settings. You don't double click it. You just click
it. Just click on,
you should have.
Click on your person once and then click initiative.
Yep.
I click on my person once and fucking nothing happens.
So click
then
on
your click initiative.
Yeah, you're selecting 0, 3, 13, whatever. Then click initiative. Yeah, you'll have
try right clicking it.
That's true. No. Yeah, right
click. No, here,
I have 2014-0. Like,
yeah.
That's
right,
all that pops up.
Yeah,
there
that's fine.
Go.
Leave it, leave it
just
like that, then click your initiative.
There you go.
You
now
click,
you're added
yeah
to the thing.
What is initiative?
Top left.
Your
on your
token. And then you like roll initiative like normal.
How do you think
oh,
you
okay
fucking rolled initiative
for an extra
last
fucking
time?
Button, dog.
No.
Okay. What is your dexterity,
but also,
Zach?
What is with the turn order?
I know, it's all messed up. I'll organize it in a sec.
Okay.
Once everybody's in here.
Alright. Leaving a great note that says, don't inspect glowing things in dungeons. Okay.
What is your dexterity, Zach?
Got it.
It could end out good, though.
I'm gonna start throwing rocks at it first.
Oh, wait, you got.
I think you need to get away from it first.
Fucking, I tried rolling a good initiative, but I got cucked the next two times, but.
Oh, look.
I fucked up saying that.
I would have had a good one. I had 18
plus
initially.
Plus 12.
Alright, hey Zach, roll a d20. Rollies.
Roll a d20? Oh, okay. Rollies. Bet 15.
Okay, Zach goes ahead of me. I've rolled a 2 again.
Well, whatever happens, Drew, I'm heading straight to you, so it doesn't matter.
I can also heal if he starts running out of spells, but
yeah,
I haven't been.
I have one more spell.
Oh, yeah, you're low on spells. Fuck.
Yep, I've got one more spell.
Yeah, I'm worried about.
Okay.
These guys better not be able to throw things. That's all I'm saying.
So you guys come in and you see this animated armor start to shoulder Zephyr a little bit. Sheikah, it's your turn. What are you doing?
A little bit. Beating the fuck out of me is what he's doing. I'm gonna die. Do guys like 100%? Sorry.
Not my turn. I throw a dart at this one.
Okay, go for it. Wait. Yeah, go for it.
Dip it. Oh shit. I don't think that hits, guys.
No, it doesn't. You go in and throw the armor, throw it at the armor, and it kind of disappears into the eye socket of the armor, and it just doesn't do anything to it.
Great, now you have it in his pussy.
Yeah, I'm gonna move a little farther away, and that's it.
The camera's off.
I know. I'll be back in a second. Okay. Is that your turn?
I have a staff. Yeah.
Okay. Win, it is now your turn.
Am I still all shalaloed up?
Yeah, we'll say that you are for this sync.
There's a tiny bug in here.
Elizabeth is not on the turn order. Oh.
What?
I agree with that message. Also, Kylie, you need to roll initiative.
There we go. I put her on.
Oh, okay.
Oof. Well, how far away is Numbnuts here?
Laura, you don't.
This is a very tiny room.
I know he's here.
Where the fuck did I put the fucking turn order, bro? I'm confused.
Drew will caress his balls.
What?
Yeah, but
he's 30 feet away from you.
Okay, where the fuck did the turn order go?
Oh yeah.
I thought I did that.
No, I closed it on accident.
Okay, but Nikki, my turn, their turn.
Oh,
they
shit.
Go next.
Right.
That's why I'm stressing.
Yeah.
I know he's gonna get some kind of opportunity swack on the back of my head, but I can probably take it. I don't trust Zach's ability to live.
I don't either.
Oh no.
So
what you gotta do, man.
I need to open my skills. Do I have healing hands? I have healing something.
This music is crazy, bro. You have cure wounds. Level one.
You need to touch it.
I know. That's why I'm sprinting over here, but this thing is gonna hit me, is it not? Or
does get an attack of opportunity.
Okay.
It's a multi-attack.
Oh no, Laura!
Question.
If we go down, it's fine.
So should I have healed from last battle?
Yeah, because we took a long rest. Yeah, we took a rest.
Okay. Yeah, we took a rest. No. You guys went straight in here. You didn't rest in between.
Yeah, we didn't.
Oh, okay.
Just have the thing hit me.
I thought you were thinking about a different battle.
So it's a 9 on the first attack.
Like 9 miss? Damage? Yeah, that misses.
Nine.
Yeah, that misses.
For the attack. Okay. And then the second one is a 10. So it goes to slam you into the wall as you're leaving, and it completely whiffs.
Cool.
Both attacks.
I'm cure wounding home slice here.
Okay, go for it.
Do I have to... What am I rolling? Okay, cast at what level?
Level one.
Dogs.
Yeah, you're fine.
Oh, thank God.
Yeah, you get 12 HP. Or max HP.
Oh, thank God.
I'm back in max. Oh, thank you, Laura.
She rolled an 8 plus her wisdom modifier.
Oh. Laura, don't you have that animal totem that gives us, like, the temporary hit points?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, she does
have
totems.
That would be nice.
Yeah. Is that a bonus?
That was her action. But the spirit of the totems, I don't know if it's bonus.
That is a bonus action. Hold on. I'm thinking
you
about
should.
I gave you a little folder too with your spirit totems, so you can.
I know. I don't know how to like. Oh, okay. So that just puts me in control of them because now when I go to be my character, I don't like. I don't know. It wants me to like be the totems instead.
No. I don't know why it's doing that. Oh, it does? Wait.
Well, I mean, like they're just under like as, and then I can fucking be my totems.
Yeah, I know that's because I want you to be able to place it wherever you want it, you know.
Okay, well I'm gonna summon one of them.
Okay.
If it is a bonus action, right?
I believe it is, but let me double check. Spirit totem.
As a bonus action, yes.
Yep. Go for it. Place it where you want.
Hold on. Bear spirit is the one I'm thinking of, right?
That was the one you used last time.
Bear. Summon bear.
You can put it down. I gave you access to the token so that way you can put it wherever you want it.
Hold on, I'm canceling input values because they're fucking cluttering my screen. Okay, how do I just summon a token?
You just drag and drop it from the journal into wherever you want it.
Bear!
But once you put it down, you can't move it, so...
That was just me like dragging and dropping it so that it appeared.
Okay.
Wait, what's its range?
It's 30 feet, I think. 60, 30, something like that. Either way, it gets everywhere.
Yeah.
It does?
It's a small
anyway,
room.
You guys
it's
have
whatever.
5 temporary hit points. Don't fuck it up.
That's 10 5? Feet away, so.
Okay.
We all do? No shit.
Let me double check.
Yeah, we all get 5.
Something like that.
You are goaded.
The spirit appears, you gain temporary hit points equal to 5 plus your druid level. I'm level 2, right?
Yeah, you're druid level
7. Just kidding, it's 7.
7 temp hit points.
Oh,
thank God.
Okay.
Ooh, I get to heal people less.
And that's your turn. Unless, you use all
your
movement. So it's a spectral totem, so you can move inside of it if you want, but it's there. Alright, now it's the armor's turn. This one is going to do the same thing to win.
Oh.
Multi-attack. It's going to try to go for win once.
Ooh.
It's a 20.
Uh-oh, that hurts.
That hits. So it does 5 damage to you. So it goes in for a slam against win, and it kind of body checks her again. And then it goes in for a slam against Zephyr.
Oh.
And that's a 10. What's your armor class?
13.
13. So it slams Win. Body checks Win, and then it goes to body check Zephyr, and Zephyr kind of dodges out of the way as it goes in for the attack. So that's that one. This one is going to... Let's see. Where do I want it to move?
How much damage did I take? 3?
3 plus 2, so 5.
Okay.
This one's going to clink, clink, clunk over to here in between two people. Or wait, it's gonna... Yeah, bang, bang. Like that. And this is going to do the same thing that the other one did to Elizabeth and Ugral. So first, I'm rolling for Elizabeth. 15. Elizabeth, what's your armor class? I think it's 14, if I remember. AC armor class, something like that.
It's right next to your 14, initiative.
Yeah. Okay, so you take 6 damage. So it kind of body checks Elizabeth, and it's going to go in for a slam against Ugral. 13.
Misses.
So it goes in for a slam against Elizabeth, body checks her, and then it goes in for another one, kind of elbows out into Ugral, and Ugral kind of dodges away, too, in the process. Okay, and that's that turn. So it's Xiaofei with Elizabeth on deck.
Quentin...
Rocking the chaos ball, motherfucker. Oh, wait, sorry. I keep forgetting I have to submit him. That shit's annoying as fuck.
Oh.
Okay, 10. So, yeah. So you go in for a chaos ball.
You might want to move.
Yeah, which one are you trying to fire?
He has such a good modifier for it, too, though.
Oh, shoot. I don't know. I have it in raise, so. Are you firing for that one?
Hold on. I have to make my map fucking bigger. Well, first I want to move.
Okay, go for that.
Because
either way, you miss. But
then never mind. Keep me fucking here.
Okay, so you go in to cast the chaos bolt, and it kind of dissipates and fizzles out in the air.
That performance anxiety.
Yeah, that performance anxiety really hit. Do you want to move, or do you have any bonus actions that you can take?
No.
Okay. I'm fucking listening.
Elizabeth, and then Ina on up next.
I would like to move over here.
Do you have access? Can you move your character now or not?
I think I can. Oh, I can. Okay.
Also, okay, Zach so should be above me in the turn order.
He should, yes. So you do get it, the armor does get an attack of opportunity on you. And it's a multi-attack. So let's see if that one hits. 11, so that one misses. And a 6, so you're fine. You take no damage from it. So, what is your plan of action now? You have an action and a bonus action.
I would like to do my Hail of Thorn spell again.
Okay. Go for it. Roll the longbow first, and then we'll add your Hail of Thorns if it hits.
Okay. Bro!
7. So you fire the arrow, and it kind of just hits inside, and you hear a clunk, 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 and then it kind of falls into the chest plate of the animated armor. And that's the end of your turn. Ina. You are up next with Zephyr on deck.
I want to do a sneak attack to the one right in front of me.
Okay, so run up on it. And so if you're flanking, you get flanking bonus, so you roll advantage.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so I don't take any sneak attack for that. Doesn't that just give you advantage?
No, it's plus damage too. So roll with advantage.
Yeah.
On your attack.
Yeah. Hello.
And it's automatically, if you are flanking, it's automatically a sneak attack. Yep, so you do plus six to whatever damage. So short. So we'll roll for your short sword now.
Yeah, we'll do short sword.
With advantage.
Oh, sorry.
So that was roll again.
Sorry.
15. So you go in for the strike, and your sword kind of just gets jammed into the armor. And, like, you go to pull it out, and then you rip it out, but no damage is taken to the armor.
It is.
Okay.
Oh, I guess it is armor. Never mind.
Zephyr, it is now your turn with Ugra on deck.
I am using Longstrider on Wynn.
Okay. So Wynn gets an extra 10 feet of movement.
And I am leaving the area. Well, the proximity.
Okay, and okay, so it does get an attack of opportunity on you if you do that.
Yep, and preparing my crossbow.
Okay. So let's see. 16? What's your, or 20? What's your armor class?
Yeah, it did that away.
Oh, no!
Well, now he's full health, but also has 7 temporary
hit
points.
Okay, so that one, the first one does 8 damage to your temp hit. 8. So you're, so minus 8. All of your temp hit points.
Not 6?
Wait, what do you mean 8?
It's plus 2.
Yeah, it's plus 2.
Yikes, so there's all of your temporary hits.
So yeah, all of your temp hit points are gone. Yeah, and then minus 1 to your normal health. And then another slam. 21, so that totally hits again.
Fucking Christ, well I'm glad I got away.
And then that one does 7 damage.
Well, you take 8 and 7.
Yeah, 8 and then 7.
I'm down to fucking 5 already? Jesus, we are leaving this fucking place. These guys are cracked. What is happening?
We should have taken a break.
I mean, when I totally gave you like a little extra get out of there too, so I pray for you, you know.
I'm gonna try to thwack it, dog. There ain't no running.
I believe in you. You know,
thwack it again. Oh all right. No.
So I'm gonna grab my holy symbol and then I'm gonna like push with it forward. And I'm gonna rise into the air and like quickly, and my eyes are gonna be bright as fuck, like headlights. And I'm gonna cast Word of Radiance. So, and that'll affect only the armor in front of me. Roll a Constitution saving throw for that armor.
Okay, which one? The one right in front of you?
Yeah.
Okay. Constitution saving throw. I don't think it has any. Plus nothing to that. Okay, so it's a normal d20. 15.
Well, it doesn't give me a thing. It doesn't give me a spell save. Do I just go with my own then?
Yeah, whatever your spell save DC is.
Alright. Well then, you see the like wave of a radiant flames come out in front of me, but the armor is not affected.
Yes.
Okay. Rats. Okay. I think Bella had to go, so I'm gonna play Bella.
Okay. Yeah, that was also my action.
I hate to ask, but is there a chance one of you guys could play for me?
Yeah, Hayden will play for you.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's all good.
I just
all good.
School and stuff.
No, it's all good.
Okay.
Adios. Take care.
Later.
Bye.
Bye.
All right, and that's my turn.
All right, Sheikah.
It's not your
turn.
Now
your turn.
Cool.
It was my turn,
javelin.
But okay.
Throwing a javelin at this guy.
Okay, go for it.
Oh, thank God.
19, that just hits.
That just hits? What do you mean it just
hits
at 19?
God.
It's armor. It's heavy armor. Okay, it takes 8 damage.
Guys,
so this one literally like dents the armor as it comes in for the hit.
Great, Nikki, guys, I dented it. Fucking yes.
And then, do you want to move or anything?
No, I will sit here at the safety next.
Okay,
to
you
the
don't have a javelin there. Anymore though.
And cry about my javelin.
Okay.
Lauren, you should pick it up to me. Yeah,
can I
throw it to me?
Can I hook it?
Can I hook it back? Sure. I'll say that you pick it up and you kind of do like an air toss to it. Or to Chica, so she has it back.
Yay, thank you.
Okay.
Right, Bunny for the win.
Oh, D20, don't fail me now. Wait, how?
Fail Laura.
Wait a minute.
Barely hit. So they have like 18. Fuck.
They have 19.
That's kind of insane.
Oh, is it 19?
Oh. I just
called it.
Barely hits. Yeah.
Is there a way to increase that?
To what?
To increase, like. It's not like a D20 plus anything.
What?
It's your wisdom for your whatever.
Oh yeah, my wisdom. Yeah. I forgot her. But even then, like, that's kind of insane.
Well, if you guys had a certain spell, it would make your lives a lot easier, but...
What
Great.
Spells do
Thank
I
you
have?
So much.
Are we, like, missing this? Are you being sarcastic that one of us has it, or are you saying we're
no,
missing
I,
it?
No, I don't know if you guys have it. But regardless, it would help for like a minute, so you would get
Great.
6 turns, or no,
10 turns.
10 turns, so, without it doing anything. Do any of you guys have Dispel Magic?
No.
I don't.
Okay.
Oh, that'd be huge.
That would be huge. And,
no, you guys can't do anything unless you can get
Oof.
So our only choice is kicking its ass, guys. I believe in us.
Woohoo!
Go for that attack.
Y'all can roll 18s consecutively.
Yeah, totally.
I mean, it's plus your wisdom.
Yeah, if you want to roll.
Laura.
Hold on, I'm looking at something.
Pog.
No.
This song's crazy.
Hey, what if I...
Sure is. This sounds...
Entangle. Grasping me for the duration, these plants turn the area into difficult terrain. A creature in the area, when you cast a spell, may succeed on a strength saving throw or be restrained. Okay. Are you doing it on that?
Well, if I do it here, I can technically get both of them.
You can. Did you I... don't have to move. It's
no. It's
the range is 90 feet, and then it's just 20
from
feet
the point
from
within range.
Oh, yeah. The range is 20.
The range is 90 feet, so you can do it anywhere from
yeah,
anywhere
the,
in the room.
The range is the
yeah.
range is 90 feet, but what does it say?
Yeah, it's a square.
Grasping weeds and vines.
Square.
In a 20-foot square.
Yeah.
Holy shit, guys! We're all gonna get tangled, aren't we? Though.
It doesn't entangle
it just
people,
turns it,
does
it? No, it turns it into difficult terrain. So,
oh, but I can
means...
fly.
A creature in the area you cast must, you cast the spell must succeed a strength saving throw or be restrained. And it's difficult terrain.
But would this be a good idea, YN?
I feel like it entangle us in it unless you can make it like smaller. And
try hitting it over here. See how big that square is.
Oh yeah, I was like, because you can just change the...
You don't have to move there.
You don't have to move, but...
Sorry, I'm trying to look at...
Oh yeah,
okay,
if
she
does it right there, then you can entangle him and not us.
Okay, yeah. Also, I'll allow that. Yeah, go for it.
Well, I just, like, now that I'm reading it more, like...
It'll be difficult for us to move over there, but I don't think
well,
any
like,
of us fucking want to.
What does it
we
do to it?
We can use ranged attacks. It tangles it. It won't be able to move.
It'll well, yeah, but like, it's so not particularly moving anyway.
Plants, well, yeah, but terrain, if we move a creature away in the area, Laura...
it must succeed a strength saving throw or be restrained and entangled by the plants until the spell ends. Creature restrained can use an action to make sure a strength check against your spell save DC, which is 4. On a success, it frees itself.
14.
14.
Yeah, 14. Yeah, might be.
Right, so Laura, imagine, so a lot of his, I think most of his attacks are like melee. Within 5 feet.
Catching our ass.
Within 5 feet, so if he can't get close to us, he can't attack us.
Okay, if you guys got range on deck, then I'm just gonna fucking hold him here then. I cast Entangle.
Are you sitting there?
I have
there?
Range.
You're moving?
Yeah, are you gonna cast
I'm
it from
sitting here.
You?
I was here. I moved here.
Well, no, he'll okay. be able to attack you though.
So yeah, he
well,
gets
no.
a
well, I'm
an
still
attack
full,
on you.
Full-ish health.
So
well, yeah, true. I mean, do you still have your hit points temporary?
17 yes. is that hit?
Yes.
Oh shit.
Okay. And then the second one is that one 5. Okay. So you
first
take 3 damage.
Yeah, I'm fine.
And now it's entangled. So. It has to make, if it wants to move on its turn, it has to make a strength save. So, am I reading that right?
Yeah,
I believe so.
It's inside of it.
Because no, difficult terrain means that it just halves your movement. So, or no, each square is 10 feet.
She's inside the spell's range.
Yeah, it's almost like I'm
casting it. Yeah, you can.
Yeah, it's a 90 range feet spell. You don't have to fucking stand inside it.
It's not the point of me.
So, it has to
I
make
it. I can cast it 90 feet away, and the range of the spell is 20 feet. Is that what I'm hearing?
Yes.
See,
which means
yes.
you.
Yes.
It's not coming from
it.
You. You can
okay,
pick,
then
pick where you want to move.
Stand here.
There you go.
Okay.
Now
it's so
just
that.
It. Yeah. Is entangled.
Be restrained?
Probably.
Now
yeah,
this
so
stupid
it has to make
asshole
a
is restrained.
Strength saving throw. Which it doesn't have any modifiers
it
to it. Which is 15, so it succeeds.
Oh no!
But it can move.
It's not entangled, but its movement is halved. Or no, it...
Okay.
Each square is 10 feet. So, like, if it were to move here, that's 10. Does that make sense?
Yeah, 10, 20,
30.
Yeah. You good, Quentin?
Yeah, yeah.
I'm muted.
Okay. But that's its turn, because it can't do anything there. So, now this one is going to go for a slam. This, the top one. It's going to go for a slam.
Grand slam.
One on...
Damn, wall. Dude, what are his... What are these
15?
Guys' rolls?
Yeah, that is. Ouch.
Okay.
They have a plus
8 damage
to
you,
roll.
And then it's gonna move down to Xiaofei.
I'm fine.
Do another
just lost
slam.
My
oh, shit.
Points.
And do a slam.
So
they're double
Zach, you do need to like
stupid.
You need to like take your health away.
Hmm?
So that hits.
Like we can't see when you're like dying because you haven't been updating your health.
No,
no
he
no,
has
I,
been.
I
it's not working.
It's
oh,
yeah,
great.
It's not, yeah, it's not working. Yeah,
okay,
I can't
so
see
hits.
Anyone, so I'm at 5 HP.
Oh.
And that does 3 damage to Quentin, so your temp hit points are now at 4, Quentin.
Oh.
Well, how is it hitting Zach?
I thought
it's
it went
not.
Down.
Or no,
it's
3.
Not.
Yeah, 3.
It,
so your
it,
temp hit points are at...
I spent 9.
It did it.
Drew healed
it hit me as I ran away.
You have temporary hit points.
Yeah, you should.
But I have a bear that's giving
you
temporary hit points.
So this is 12.
Yeah.
You had 7 temporary hit points, but it hit you for 3, so then it went down to 4 temporary hit points. That makes sense? And Ugral and Ina get attack of opportunities on it.
True.
So...
Would mine just be my hit dice? Because I don't... I'm not, like, holding anything.
Just smacks it.
No, you don't have to hold. If you're, do you want to use the same spell again?
Hey, fuck it.
Well, okay, then yeah. You just
make a constitution saving throw.
Oh, why is it doing it in advantage? That's so whack.
Because she had it in advantage. Because it was advantage, right. Yeah. Oh, I guess mine should have been advantage too. Actually, no, it doesn't matter. I don't roll for attack.
24 plus.
Oh, thank God, I hit.
Okay, and then he makes a strength saving throw?
Constitution.
Wait, so do I just get skipped for a move?
Okay.
No. Well, then, yeah.
No, you are. You're not.
Shrugs
it's not
off
yet.
The spell. Spell dissipates.
I can hurt it, right?
Yep, now it's your turn. And it's right in front of you, 5 feet.
What the fuck is this spell called?
Would he have advantage for this?
Shocking grass. There you go.
Is that thing flanking?
No. This is spectral. It doesn't affect
That's
it.
My move.
Yeah, so you see Xiaofei's fingertips light up, and he goes to electrocute the animated figure, and it kind of shocks it, and it kind of stuns it for a bit, but then it comes back, and it...
How much health does this have?
More than 5.
Well, it should have took, what, the 6 piercing, right?
That was the other one.
That's it for me.
No, it's still this one.
Okay.
Oh, from Bella? Yeah.
I'm still at whatever.
Can you guys see the bar now around it?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
What the fuck, man?
Fuck! This bitch has taken 11 damage so far.
Still over half. This guy's goated.
Holy fuck, bro.
We're so fucked.
I don't know why it wasn't. Yeah, I'm turning everybody's on. I didn't.
Okay, now I can see the fact that Zach is holding on for dear life.
Now I'm fucking scared. Yeah, dude, he fucking cracked on me. He's like, okay, I'll just do 3 health to Quentin.
It's fucking 2 attacks or bullshit.
There you go. Oh, yeah, and Kylie has 7 HP.
Why do you think I got away?
Everybody, check your spells for dispel magic.
What is this music?
I don't know. It's kind of crazy.
It's intense. I'm scared.
Okay. And that's Xiaofei's turn. It is now Ina's turn. Let's see. She's going to... Oh, shit. I'm still in box. Sprint over here and fire an arrow at the animated armor. Sorry, I have so many character sheets that I gotta go through. Yeah. Okay. Longbow. Oh, that's
Fuck.
So sad. Nope, doesn't hit. So the arrow goes wide.
It's not a good day for Elizabeth, bro.
It is now Ina's turn. Ina's gonna move here and go for a short sword attack, sneak attack. Because it's flanking. Or no, is it flanking?
No.
It's not.
It can be
normal.
Flanking if you're next. If you're on top of the fucking bear.
Yeah. True. I'll just stand here and do it. So she would get advantage. True. I'm trying to help you guys. These guys are tanky.
They sure are. They're tanky and they're attacky.
Yeah.
No shit.
Fuck these guys, dude.
So she has advantage with the short sword. 19. Okay, sweet. Woo! And it's a sneak attack. So that's 1d6.
9 damage.
4, so 9 damage.
A gog champ, bro.
9 damage. Why isn't his health going down?
Because I didn't change it yet.
Oh, thank God. Okay, great. We have to do just like 18 more.
Sorry, you have to say 14 more hits of it.
Yeah, right.
Chip away at these assholes.
Yeah, just 15 more. It'll be fine.
Okay, Zephyr, it's your turn.
Alright, fucking, let's get it. Okay, I don't have to, wait. Let me get out of their way.
This is a straight up line. A line of tokens.
It sure is.
So I am going here. Actually, you know what? I'm a little bit further back. I'm going there. And I'm using Chaos Bolt. We're doing that right now.
I might
now.
Like to join everybody. I'm at level.
You? Where are you at?
Your Chaos Bolt will hit.
You can do 18. Got it.
You'll just throw things at the one in the corner.
What do I do for this?
Point left.
Okay, so you roll 1d20. Or no, make a ranged spell attack. So... 1d20 plus your spell modifier, which would be, I think it's charisma. I think you have charisma. No, intelligence. So click on, if you go to core and click on intelligence with the 3 and the 16, click intelligence. Three. See if it hits on the left. 9. So that it fizzles out right before you were able to cast it.
Damn.
That's fucked.
You use your well, you got any bonus actions you can take?
I do.
Your armor class is so high.
I'm hiding behind Kylie.
Okay, deal. Ugral, yeah. It's your turn.
Heat shield.
Alright. I'm gonna move there. And I'm gonna cast the same fucking spell.
Okay.
I'm gonna cast it until it hits. Roll a constitution saving throw.
You got it!
Fuck you! That's the second fucking nat 20 on that shit! God damn it.
Hey guys, so have we had the idea of leaving? Just say fuck can these we? Guys?
Yeah, no. You know, I'm gonna go over here and I'm gonna look for an exit.
It's an attack of 30.
These guys are going.
I'm still gonna do it. I'm still fucking doing
it. Let's go get the royal
let's go
army.
This guy is
17.
Fuck my ass. Yeah, that hits. That hits too.
Why did you run?
Both of those fucking hit.
These things are gonna fucking squad wipe us.
Dude, why are they rolling so high?
7 plus 4.
That's what I'm saying.
That's my health.
Plus 4, but that's still insane.
I'm down.
You have.
You have a. Oh yeah, that's all the time. Drew is unconscious.
If I am unconscious.
God damn it, Drew.
These kills Drew.
Let's just leave him on the floor.
Don't forget you can heal me to bring me back.
Yeah, you can. You can heal to bring him back. She gets your turn.
Yikes, I can't heal.
You're rolling high.
Dude, they fucking roll
can you believe
high
that this
every
was,
time.
Can you believe that this was for, level 2 characters. This was a book made for level 2 characters.
You're lying!
I'm dead ass.
I'm dead ass.
Cool. Whoops. Let's see.
What are you doing?
You are.
So,
stop it.
Wind tossed you the javelin back. So you have the javelin.
I know. Does it affect,
yes.
Lulith if I throw a dart to this bitch?
Yeah.
Yes. It would go to through her.
That'll be fine. Okay, I'll throw a dart at this one.
Okay, go for it.
Please, fucking... Son of a bitch!
Fucking just motherfucker. Misses.
So, I like my idea.
I'm leaving?
We might have to peace out on these guys and go get some help from the...
Yeah, from the people
after this, you can take a short rest. I allow that.
Yeah, short rest. I don't feel like going
back
to town.
I mean, you
would
hear chanting in the room, but...
We don't have
know,
to go back
fine.
To town. We can just set up.
Yeah, you know what? If rest. These guys are just beginning of those
town.
Guys, we might have to go back to... Yeah.
Nah, you can short rest in here.
You can just take a nap.
Win, Triskel, it is now your turn.
How many spell slots do I have?
3, I believe.
Oh, does it not show your total either?
Well, I've got one
what
more
this?
Then.
What?
You use Entangle.
Oh, no, I just put
and
that.
And Cure Wounds.
Yeah.
So, yeah, you have one more. One remaining.
I'm Cure Woundsing Dum Dum over here.
Okay.
Oh.
After I figure out how.
you just run over and...
Well, yeah, I know. I just have to, like...
1d8 plus your spellcasting ability.
Which is wisdom, so...
Or I could just...
Plus 4.
1d8 plus your... Oh, yeah, 9. You got 9 HP.
How did you roll a 9?
It's plus your wisdom modifier, so 5 plus 4.
Oh, shit. I didn't know it added it on.
I do
there.
A fuck okay. ton, dude.
I didn't know that it added.
Anyway,
that
was that my action or what was that?
Yeah, that's your action. Yeah. So you have a bonus action if you want. This song is annoying me. Okay. All right. This is taking a lot longer than I expected. Okay, is that your turn?
Always does.
I guess so.
Okay. It is now the animated armor's turn, so it's going to move like this. 5, 10, 15, 20, and that's all it can do.
Oof.
Okay, this guy is going to slam on Xiaofei and then Ina, or try to. 13 on Xiaofei, which just hits.
Oof.
So Xiaofei takes 4 damage. And then 17 on... Oh, man. It's all...
Yeah?
Bella's 10 hit points.
It's all of it?
Yep. 7. Okay. And that's all that for the turns. Okay, Xiaofei, it's your turn.
Wait, so is Bella down?
No, Bella's not down. She has 11 HP.
I'm saying fuck this shit and I leave.
Okay. Xiaofei, could you say anything as you're running away?
I say, good luck, motherfuckers. Peace out. These fuckers are fucking hurt. I don't give a fuck.
He actually dips out on us.
Bro, there's no fucking way. I don't do shit, bro. I did 3 damage.
No, you didn't. More than like 5.
That's more than better what than... I did. Yeah, that's better than what I've done, bro.
Yeah, I just
got fucking pummeled like a fucking boxing mat. Like, what do you mean?
It was your fucking idea.
I walk into the room and he's like fucking smacking the shit out of me like a ragdoll. Like,
I'm out, bro. I'm out. I don't give a fuck.
All right, bye. Bye, Xiaofei.
All right. You go up the stairs. We'll say that you're gone. But he does get an attack of opportunity as you leave. It's a crypt leading down. But he does get an attack of opportunity on you as you leave. That one misses.
Took my dick.
And that one misses too. So Quentin is like, look all this, bobbing and weaving, and then sprints up the stairs.
I hate the fact that there's 2 of them.
hey, Zach.
If there's one, we might have had a chance, you're right.
If you run, we can come back later, motherfuckers.
How about we find a fucking room or anything?
Taking a shot on that. 16, it misses. Elizabeth's turn. Elizabeth or Ina. Holy shit, there's so many.
I have
E's.
An idea, dude.
Is going
to I feel about that.
Bella needs to back the fuck off for a second, though.
And don't forget
Zach. Can you get Bella to move away a little bit? Just
yeah, I'll move her.
Okay.
Don't forget, there's everything in here is 10 feet instead of 5 because of the spell Laura used.
There we go. And where do you want her to move?
I mean, upward. Somewhere. Like, just. Yeah.
Okay. Sure thing.
So everything in here is 10
Yeah, everything
feet
in
five?
That big square,
everything
yeah.
in the box is, yeah, you takes 10 feet of movement.
How do you
every
do the
square?
Fucking square, by the way?
So I'd only be able to
you
go...
You just 50. Click it.
So by technicality, I'd only be able to go 15 feet, is what you're saying.
Yeah, you can go into the box.
Yeah. Ina's looking pretty hurt.
Just everything in here is worth 10 instead of 5.
Ina sure is, damn. But that armor is too.
It is now Zephyr's turn.
So my max movement's 30 feet, so I'd only be able to move to here, right?
Well, no, you're not in the box yet.
Wait, where's the box? I'm sorry.
That's the box.
Here.
I'll just hold it here.
Okay, so I can move here, correct? Or here? Actually,
no. Yeah, do that one.
Okay, so yeah, I'm doing that. I'm moving there.
Okay. So you sprint because, by. Because, watch it, Elizabeth. Yes. Sprint by.
Yeah, so I'm like, get the fuck out of my way. Thank you for being my bodyguard, but I got shit to do. And I'm using Tasha's chaotic. Caustic brew, sorry.
Okay, so he has to make a dexterity saving throw. And if he fails, it does 3 damage. 9, so it fails, so he does. You do 3 damage to the boy.
No, wait, have you read on that? It's supposed to be a line, it goes completely across.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Yeah. So it's a straight line. It's a 5-foot wide.
And it's a 30-foot line. Yeah. I see that. Okay.
Ooh, he's thinking.
Yeah, that is both.
He's using
like
his
that.
Brain.
Yeah, that's perfect.
Yeah.
Ah, damn. That is perfect.
Yep. Okay, sweet. So yeah, that totally hits. So it's 3 to both. Is that what it is?
Yeah.
Or do you have to do 2 dexterities?
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. So the second one fails.
Ah, you bitch. I was hoping for the second one to be it.
This one stays alive, but this one hits, and it does 3 acid damage.
Burn the bitch.
Burn, bitch, burn.
Oograwl, it is your turn.
Alright, after my near-death experience that I had, I'm gonna...
Wake up.
Wait, hold on, that was 25 feet. I'm gonna take a step back, though.
And you were wake prone. Up. You were prone because you fell unconscious. So it'll be half your movement to stand up.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Right, I'm gonna wake up and I'm gonna see this fucking sexy-ass rabbit person anyway. And I'm gonna...
yeah.
And I'm gonna... touch her, and I'm gonna give her guidance again.
Okay.
Deal. So, and I'll put that in chat again, so you guys can see that. And then I'm gonna use half my movement to get up, and then I'm gonna do what I was gonna do earlier and look around the room.
Okay.
For like an exit of any kind other than the one that I already had.
Make a perception check.
Fucking natural one.
Oh no!
You look around, it's kind of dark in here. Days. You notice some doors up here, but that's it.
Uh-huh. Where?
Up near the top.
Cool.
Okay.
Oh, yeah,
she
still found some. Oh, I'm gonna relay that to everybody. Yeah, I'm gonna relay that. I'm gonna be like, there's a fucking door over there. Except, there's a door over there.
Good door. Okay.
Good door.
I'm moving to this dude. And I'm doing Monk Unarmed. But I will do a key point to be able to do it 3 times.
Deal.
Okay. So that one doesn't 12. Work.
Yeah. First one misses.
Once again.
That one also. Second one misses.
Okay. Your roll is so okay. Bad. I know.
You have +6.
Oh, thank
God. Oh.
+7.
Double the dice.
So 14 then.
6 + 1,
it says.
2, so 2, so 4 + 4 is 8. So this guy.
Where the fuck are you getting the 8?
Okay, so you rolled. It's a d4 20. +4. So you rolled a 2, so you doubled that, which is 4.
+4.
+4, which is your dex modifier. So you do 8 damage. So.
Oh, I thought it automatically did it down here.
It does crits differently than we do.
Oh, okay. So 8 damage. Thank God. Fuck
this
bitch.
He is standing on his last legs. You have dented this piece of armor completely.
Come on, somebody just
fucking spit on it.
Flick his forehead.
Just wait, it's your turn. Son of a bitch!
Drew, give him the old dick twist!
Wait, so it's this not my turn yet, but... This is the fellow that's...
Yeah, this guy's
on
almost
his
dead.
Last fucking legs!
Come on, I believe in
it's
you.
It's like one hit point! What the fuck? I thought I got him.
Let's see if I whiff, boys.
Oh my god,
please. Don't, Laura. 18. 18.
Yeah, all
you
need is wisdom.
Sheet.
And now 100% win hits this shit. All she does is kill things.
No. She's been missing her wisdom the entire time.
You jinxed it. Okay, so you go in for a swing and it kind of...
Come on, bro. What is that nat 20 from the beginning of the session?
Bruh.
Okay, so this one...
Oh, you're right.
This session's gonna go so well.
Oh, that Zephyr, no!
5, 10.
Oh, 15, for the 20. Love of God. Oh.
That's as far as it can move.
Oh, thank God.
This guy.
Deep breath. Deep breaths. I'm surviving, guys.
You got
this. Top guy is gonna roll an attack. 19 on win for 23, so that hits.
Oh, shit.
With a 3, so 5 damage to win.
Bruh.
And a 14 on Sheikah, which
doesn't
misses.
Hit.
Sweet. Okay, and that's a turn.
I still have all my
Zhao
health.
Xiaofei, are you up the stairs, like, peeking in, or what are you doing here?
You dead?
Quentin.
What are you doing here?
Quentin!
Here.
You've sprinted up the stairs, but you're still around.
This dude's at one hit point! You just gotta...
Just hit it once.
I'm not in the building.
What are you doing? I said that you were on top of the stairs, and you can look into the crypt if you want.
How can I look into it?
Yeah, it's a door. You opened the doors and went into the crypt. So the doors are still open, and you're looking in.
I leave.
Okay, you run away.
So just take him off
wait,
of the turn
am I
order?
At on the map?
Out? Like,
out. You technically aren't in the map.
And yeah, not this
we'll
map.
Say for sake of narrative, you're up there. You're up the stairs.
I'm possible to hit this guy.
Yes.
Please do. He has like one hit point left.
Nikki, how much
he's
do you
he's so close
me?
To dead.
How much do you appreciate me?
I appreciate you a lot if you killed him.
No shit. I can agree with that one.
Come on, baby. Get an 18 on whatever you're gonna roll.
Come on. For the love of everything, this bitch needs to die.
Well,
I'm a bitch. This is so stupid.
Okay.
Why are they rolling high? It's rigged. It's rigged.
It's not, I promise you. I'm just clicking. I'm just clicking.
They
I've clicked normal this entire time. Okay, it's Ina's turn.
That's Elizabeth.
Or, yeah, Elizabeth, and then Ina, and then, yeah. Okay, longbow.
Please
do something. 13.
Ooh, 18.
18,
oh,
that just hits.
God.
1d8, and it's Hail of Storm, too, so it's 1d8 plus 3. So 4 damage. And then he has to make a wisdom saving throw. What is wisdom?
Motherfucker.
See?
You got weighted dice.
You sure did. the fuck, GM?
So, either way. It does one damage. So, it does a total of 4 plus 2, 6 damage to this guy.
Oh, thank God.
That's
some damage.
Could have been a lot better, but it is still not bad.
That's better, yeah. That's still damage.
There we go. Okay. It is now Ina's turn. Ina is going to sprint down here and then run under this torch and kind of slice it on its way over. Sorry. Too many character sheets.
Get in here. Come on, get in here.
With advantage.
Oh, please.
Oh,
no. Either way, we'll take that.
Yeah,
we'll
that is fucking
even though it had advantage.
For the love of God.
Yeah, it kills it. Either way.
Dead.
Yeah. So this guy is on the ground. The armor pieces are scattered across the floor. Let me double check something real quick.
Somebody kick the fucking armor pieces away.
Nope. So the armor pieces are too dented and scattered to, and the magical aura around it that Zephyr saw is now gone.
I swear to God, if it's a bitch, that can come back to life.
I had to make sure it wasn't, but now it is Zephyr's turn.
All right.
Zephyr, run.
That's definitely happening.
I would back up a bit.
Yeah, definitely doing that. So... should I go to this side? What's that distance? That's...
You can make it. Totally.
Okay, yeah, totally. Okay, now we're doing Firebolt. Okay, pray to God. Armor. Oh! Thank God.
Yes!
Oh,
two fire damage.
Huge damage, bro.
And the fucking skin of our teeth will beat these bitches.
You set out a firebolt. Is there a burn? No, it doesn't burn it.
Damn.
But it does hit it for two damage.
But, okay, and I got extra 5 feet. I'm moving up an extra 5 feet. I'm taking it.
Okay, fucking. Go for it.
Okay.
Alright.
Ugral.
I am going to... I'm gonna pull out my quarter staff and just stand at the edge of the thing. Let's see how big it is. So I'm gonna stand
You can stand there if you want without taking
a turn. I don't know. Maybe not that close. Maybe just here.
Okay.
I'll stand there, and I will hold my action until it gets close enough. If it does,
okay.
And I'll just fucking beat it.
Okay.
Cheat its ass.
It's your turn.
Cool. I throw my javelin at him. Please, for the love of God, do
get
it.
Get a crit. I pray to God.
Bitch.
Oh, no.
I missed my crit on the other one. It's in the weeds. I'll grab it later, guys.
Is that your action?
Yeah, that's all I can do.
Okay. Wynn, it's your turn.
Do I have anything ranged? Or do I have to approach?
Do you have cantrips that are ranged?
No, I only have... maybe don't quote me on that.
You have...
Hello, character sheet. Good morning. No.
Nope, nothing ranged.
Well, I have 10 extra movement, so I can get his ass. It's just gonna be annoying being in the field.
Yep.
Oh god, you're gonna put yourself in the field?
Well, I'm gonna try. So this would be... 5... Fair move. You're a bitch. 10, 15, and then does it start here?
20, yeah, 25 is
here. Yeah, you're in the range already, yep.
20, 25.
Let's find out what fucking happens.
Well, good luck.
Well, like, there's no tomorrow, dog. I'm on my hands and knees.
Wisdom.
Big and please.
That was with advantage.
Why do I have advantage on, dog?
God damn it, Laura, we could have used that.
That was so good!
We just roll that again. Advantage.
Yeah! She snuck up on him in the weeds, it's her natural habitat. She runs right in.
God damn it.
Son of
a
bitch!
A good roll.
I don't even know how it got put on advantage. I didn't touch
it.
Man. Are you fucking with my character sheet, dog?
No, I haven't. I haven't clicked on anything, I promise you. Either way, it's gonna go 5, 10, 15, 20, and stand there.
Oh,
so,
no.
Drew, use your action.
Yeah. Oh, would it be one-handed or two-handed?
Whichever you want. I'll say that you were kind of holding it like this. So you're going, pop, pop.
Two-handed.
Yeah.
hit him for 2 damage. Oh wait, no, I have to roll an attack first. I forgot about that. I miss.
Okay. So he stands there, and you go in for a swing, and it just like right in front of him.
It's a little short.
So he's gonna go for a slam attack on you. Misses. And then it goes for a slam attack on Wynn. Oh, I did take away it. 9. So yeah, they both miss.
Oh, thank God.
Good.
She's rolling bad too.
It's your turn. Wynn
makes his returning debut and just stomps this guy.
What do you want to do here? You're still upstairs.
We killed one. This guy is. If we all just wail on him.
Quentin? I don't think he's even at his computer at this point.
I think he's just done, man.
No, I'm here.
Okay. What you doing?
I'm figuring it out.
Very good.
We technically gang up on the thing, we could kill it.
We could. We just there's enough of us. It's less than half.
I'll say that you do have a little bit of height advantage, so yeah, if you want to make a direct line from your character to the thing, it probably could hit because you have a little bit of height advantage because of the stairs. Okay, or you can move in like that. Sure thing. Strength saving throw. 13.
Why is he strength saving?
It still hits. So 6 damage.
No shit.
Yeah. So 6 damage. This thing's looking not. The armor is very dented. Right now.
So we need to do like what 8 or something, son of a bitch. Box.
Ina or Elizabeth, might be. Yeah. Is going to fire another arrow at it.
Oh. Bro, she's right here. Please.
5 misses. Dang. And then Ina is going to do the same thing with her short bow. Goes in for a short bow attack. Oh, that's with advantage. No, it isn't. 21. It hits.
Oh, thank God.
Some damage. It looks fairly hurt.
Come on, guys, we're so close.
Zephyr, it's your turn.
Alright, am I still in direct line for a crossbow?
You were technically in direct line for crossbow.
Okay, well, actually, you know what? I didn't like that line. I still need to get a little bit of a distance. Then with my the repeating shot crossbow.
Go for it.
Boom! There's one. There's two.
Both miss.
No, dude, this fucking guy. Please.
Our only hope.
You still have movement if you want.
Yeah, that's true. I'm gonna progress towards here. That was like what 5? I mean,
yeah.
He's sneaking away.
Yeah. Okay. I'm fine with that.
All right, Ugral and then Sheikah.
I'm gonna cast Word of Radiance again.
Go for it.
Constitution saving throw.
17.
I'm gonna fucking lose it.
Bullshit.
Do you want to move? You can move. But it gets an attack of opportunity.
Well, it's not gonna get an attack of opportunity if I go like this.
True.
I'll give Laura an advantage.
No, Wynn is flanking. Sheikah.
My turn?
It's your turn. Your turn.
Cool. I coming here, and then monk unarmed.
Okay, go for it.
For the love of God! Yes.
That hits. You knock it to the ground.
My fucking
and
God!
And the thing, the armor is scattered across the floor.
Woohoo!
Let's go check out that fucking door. There's definitely some people.
Shut the fuck up. Well, I am taking a nap.
Oh, yeah. You know what? I forgot about taking a nap.
Yeah.
All right.
Hey, can I pick up my darts and javelin?
Yeah, I'm picking up my one.
And Laura's thing is down there.
Crossbow bolt. Okay.
Me and Lucky have worked in like 5 hours.
Thrown in a short rest. Roll 0d8 2 available. What's this?
We sure do.
I hit short rest and it's telling me roll and it's giving me something d8.
Yeah, so so you
should
roll.
Should we have something with our exhaustion level?
No. That's a whole different thing.
Okay.
Me serving cunt.
Hit dice. So I roll a d8?
We roll both of our hit dice or just one of them?
So then I put in a 7 for what I rolled? Okay.
Yes, so now you have one available hit dice. Holy shit.
What the fuck?
What just happened?
I don't know why you did that. Okay.
I'm confused. So wait,
have one hit dice available. You rolled a 7, so 5 plus 7 is 12. So you have 12.
I'm so confused.
So whatever your hit dice die is,
for that much.
You heal that many hit points, okay. But you take away one.
Yeah, so just click on short rest. Yeah, just click short rest. And then
do we really want to push this at this point now?
Oh, but I don't need to heal.
No, but it gives you like spell slots back and shit. Just hit short rest.
Yeah. Give me my
That's a long rest.
I don't think so. I think you regain key points with long rest.
Yeah, spell points are just long rest. Yeah, short rest is just
my age. I didn't take any damage.
Okay, well then don't roll a hit dice.
Well, okay, so I just hit short rest and it didn't do anything.
You have to do the hit dice.
Where is that?
When you click short rest, doesn't it pop up?
Oh. Yes.
Roll it to
but
one.
It doesn't let me do anything.
Do you have to click up to one?
Click up one.
Yeah, and that doesn't fucking okay. Yeah, no,
then click roll.
I see now. Well, okay, I hit up one and it wasn't showing up the first.
So you gain 9 HP. So you're at max, just Laura.
Just
Quentin 20? Gained 4 HP. He's at max. He still has 2 bonus hit points.
Does that also give you guys spell slots?
No.
That's long rest.
Yeah, no, that's only long rest.
Yikes, guys, let's just take a nap.
That's what we're doing.
A long rest? 8 hours? You want to sleep 8 hours here?
I don't know about
Not
that.
Really. At that point, whoever's chanting in that cave is going to get up and do something.
Yeah, can I perception
anything? We're
going to
wake up in the middle of anything? Dead.
Can I perceive the room?
Yeah, I want to...
Yeah. Go ahead, roll perception check.
I also want to investigate the armor now. And can I
click? Is it possible to collect the armor?
I cannot perceive shit!
Don't forget to roll for Ina and Elizabeth's thing.
So, yeah, I already did.
Unperceiving.
Oh, okay. So, Ina didn't
Guys, I'm
heal.
Blind.
Wait, hold on.
Why do you keep rolling perception, Dum-Dum?
Why would she...
I don't know. I have a 3 plus to it. I don't know why I just can't percept.
And I have a 6 plus.
Okay, do you want me to do a perception for you?
Please do.
Can I do?
Okay.
Hello?
Perceive and let us know.
There you go.
See? Zach, what the fuck?
My investigation and perception's great, but everything else, apparently, it sucks. I can get That's one fair. Hit in the entire
so
fucking
So, you look around, the armor is broken, beaded, everything. But
not,
the only
not
thing
worth
that's...
scavenging.
Yeah, not worth scavenging, but the only thing that you see that looks of interest in the room is that door.
Oh. Fuck that door.
That I door know, is... I'm like, I feel
like
the boss
after,
waiting to
yeah,
happen.
After fucking going against that, I feel like that's going to be a struggle without the majority of our spells.
So
let alone Zhao Fei.
And plus, it's almost 2 in the morning.
Are you gonna...
Is it really?
Yeah. So maybe we should leave the crypts and then camp out in the graveyard? Or near it?
Okay, let's go behind the fucking house.
The crypt?
Yeah, the crypt. Yeah.
So exit will
go
behind
I feel like if we sleep,
there.
They're gonna be gone.
Yeah, they're just gonna leave. Like, we can't let them
You're
leave.
Saying that you wanna go and do a boss battle right now?
I mean, it's not like we have a choice.
I feel like
is it a boss battle?
We don't know. Someone peek their head in there to see.
I don't know. Right. How about we go find out?
Can we do an investigation cup to the door check?
Does yeah. anyone yeah. have a so, cup?
Somebody should like go. Yeah, peek yeah. through the door.
Okay. Who's doing it? Who's opening the door?
Wait a minute. Wait. I still have detect magic, and that's on top of where is that? I need to find it.
How long the fuck does that last?
Hold on. Would I have an idea of the structural integrity of this building and its undercarriage for me being? Hold on. I'm trying to find it. Item fuse now repeating shot.
What are you trying to find out?
I should have an understanding like this entire. I mean, where is that? I'm not seeing it. Dark vision. Like,
I'm fucking with my bear. Ignore
Urban
me.
Urban infrastructure. Oh, that's probably just within. Okay. Here, I'm gonna just put that in there and see what you guys think of what it says.
It's a
bedtime. Including the stuff behind the walls.
Yeah, basically.
Oh, interesting.
Okay.
Yeah, you see what I'm saying?
Secret spaces.
Yeah, so there's no secret rooms in this area. You can tell. You can tell that it looks very looks very like solid in its
right.
fortitude. What is that circle? What the fuck?
That's my bear. I can change it to have a circle showing.
Oh, that's sick.
I actually can't see it, but...
I can see it.
What circle?
Okay. Do that.
Okay, so it doesn't show me. I just double-clicked on the token and...
Oh, I see it! That's awesome! And so that's its range?
Yeah, aura 1 radius, and then I just put 30 feet in a circle. And I can technically
have a circle. Send the bear in!
She can't
move
it.
Can I have the bear go peeking?
You can't move it.
But yeah, you can tell that there's about 5 other rooms in this building. There's a room directly behind the west wall, like based on how the map looks, like this one.
Okay.
You can see that you can tell that there's a room over there. There's a room here, a room here, and then another room further up.
What the fuck?
But it's all led through that one door.
Yeah.
Okay, well, everybody...
You know what, guys? I'm gonna let you decide on that one. I got details for us, but I don't know what the fuck to do at this
while
point.
While everybody's just standing around, I'm gonna go peek inside the room.
Yeah, I got peek too.
Okay.
Please don't trigger them.
So,
yeah, I'm gonna, like,
this is
the door
what you see.
Oh, wait. I want to inspect... Can I inspect for traps first?
Nah, let Drew just do it.
I'm assuming there aren't any.
Or, yeah, Drew
is it dark for you?
Yeah.
Okay,
but it says cultists.
Yeah, I do see those. I do see the 4 cultists, but, you know.
Why is that on?
I don't know.
That's so wack.
I know, I was like, guys, there's 4 more people for us to fight. Plus or minus more... Can we really not just like camp outside the door and not let them escape?
What if they like?
I
want to
barricade the armor against the door.
They
get unmovable.
Laura can just leave her bear and intimidate them.
Can you see that?
It's just a spirit token.
What?
We can pretend.
No, you can't see anything. Okay, I gotta turn off dynamic lighting. Yeah. You don't see the guys in there right now, but
okay.
Why is it not?
I do have dark vision.
I know, but okay. Yeah, so you would be able to see this, but
see the. Oh, okay. I can see into the room, but I haven't rolled for perception yet.
I know. I don't know why it's being very glitchy right now.
11.
Okay. Okay. This room is very bare. It looks like just a hallway in this room.
This room looks pretty clear to me.
Oh.
There you go. This is what you see.
This room doesn't look like a room, it's a hallway. I can't see anything.
Investigation check too.
All right.
The fuck is that in the room?
Five.
Five? Yeah, you don't. It looks very, very bare in here.
I'm not seeing anybody in here.
Great. Go take a nap.
Hooray. No, I don't trust Drew.
Do you want to go in here?
No, I'm good. It's kind of sus.
I'm not sure we can handle
an investigation check, Jack. Zach?
Huh? Investigation?
Roll an investigation check.
I got you. Alright, where we at? Oh, that's like my worst one. See, I had no faith in it.
Yeah, this hallway looks very bare. Besides the cultists that you aren't supposed to see in the next room.
Can we hear them though?
Yeah, they're kind of talking amongst themselves.
Never mind, it doesn't sound clear. It looks clear, but it's
they can definitely hear you too.
Oh yeah.
I was about to say, I'm like, well, they'd totally hurt us fighting if we could hear them chanting.
You know what? That's actually fair.
I'm gonna stop shouting. I think
armor.
I think we should leave. Yeah, I'm gonna wink. I think we should leave.
I'm gonna be like, I agree, wink wink.
I also agree.
Are we gonna end the session here?
We can end the
session. We can do either. I'm down.
Oh yeah, it's
Alright, we need to put a vote in.
Yeah, okay. Who wants to end the session now and we pick up exactly where we left off, same HP, everything?
Me.
Yeah, I'd say we could do that because I kind of do want to fight them.
One's in chat for starting the same spot tomorrow.
Tomorrow?
Tomorrow, let's
go! I'm down for tomorrow.
It's already tomorrow.
It'll start a bit
I was gonna say, that'd be 12 o'clock, 100%.
Yeah, it would be later, but...
Oh, shit. I don't think anybody else is down for tomorrow.
I don't think anybody else is actually... I'm pretty sure that was a joke.
But I don't work Saturday, so it's okay.
Like, I don't think everybody can do it, but...